I got. G'day guys! Alright Taz! That's my mate PhatCruiser! We're here riding through Middlesex, slowly heading towards Sheffield after an epic day one riding west coast to Tasmania. Just been exploring the sights of Cradle Mountain, the local wildlife park up there that specialises in Tasmanian devil, showing PhatCruiser some of the local sights. So this area is called Middlesex, or the Middlesex Plains. And it's characterized by all these dead trees that you can see around us. Some of that is historic logging. Some of it is logging changing the microclimate. A lot of it has to do with drought that we've experienced in the last 10 years. And it's all just combined to kill off a lot of the eucalypts. And it gives an almost moonlight landscape. Makes it quite spectacular. You can see the building. That's Middlesex Plains Station. And it's basically running cattle. They own a lot of the land east of Cradle Mountain down towards Moena, and through the summer they run cattle, and then through the winter they take those cattle down to lower lying ground to protect them from the elements. Quite fertile plains here. The grassland supports a lot of native fauna, and Europeans have occupied this area since about the 1850s, give or take, trapping, snaring, running cattle. Historically, there's a bit of mining. This is Wooning Paddock Creek, and if you follow that creek down through to that area there, you get to quite a spectacular waterfall, and then from that waterfall down there's a man-made race fueling a mine, and that race actually goes all the way down to Moena. Apparently, it took a team of about 8 men 3 years to build it, and it fueled some of the gold mines, like the Narra Creek gold mine that I explored in one of my dual sport videos. locally, this is referred to as the Hunting Lodge, and it's a historic site. It was once used by trappers and snarers, and even today it's owned by a group, Hunt and Hound or something like that, that uses it pretty much every long weekend. We can get back to Sheffield from Cradle Mountain in about an hour. Historically, this would have been a cart track. Just up here to the right, that was Post Office Tree. And that was a supply drop-off between Moena and Cradle Mountain, and basically people could leave their mail. There's sort of a ration cupboard where supplies were placed that people could pick up and drop off. So even though there's nothing there today, this is Daisy Dell, and Daisy Dell used to be quite a massive town that operated logging operations. And there's the old historic site for the mill. There's a heap of old sawdust piles and pits. So through the late 1800s, early 1900s, right up till about the 1930s before it closed, thousands of people would have existed in this area. So scattered right through all this bushland, there's historic ruins of cabins and mines and sawmills, etc. Just an incredibly rich historic area. You look in there, there's Bull Creek, there's a cabin just up in there that was restored not too many years ago. Jacks. And again, if you duck down in that road that you saw down through there, it's another historic mine. They used to mine gold, silver, tin, wolfram right through this area. Lake Gardner down in there. I've explored that in a recent series of videos. It's Dolcoth Road. Went down to Lake Sathana via Dolcoth Road in a recent three-part series that it was very successful. And in an upcoming video, I explore down in there on my dual sport and come across some amazing old gold mine ruins. Coming down the hill from Moena into coming down the hill from Moena towards Safana. Mount Van Dyke in front of us, Mount Roland to the left. Plenty of tourist traffic at this time of night, so I'm just taking it nice and easy. Got PhatCruiser, who's not used to the roads, so just nice and easy, no race. thus concludes day one of the Epic.